Meanwhile, the Dow diving nearly 800 points at the worst part of the session, in part to those trade woes, before it began cutting those losses. So what do these wild swings actually mean for your money? I want to bring in market watchers Gary Kaltbaum and Melissa Armo. We're also joined by FBN's Charlie Gasparino. Charlie, let me start with you. Obviously, it was interesting because this headline, the news started last night, came out of it, right. You know, it happened Sunday. For some reason, we just found out about it yesterday. It hit the futures market really hard, and we started under a tremendous amount of pressure. What do you make of it, though? Will this impact the trading negotiations?
You mean the arrest of the CFO from the Chinese company? Yeah. Listen, the market thinks it will, and I can tell you, traders all day today were telling me they think it's bad for the market. As you know, the market backed up or came back, I should point out, on the Fed basically going slow with normalizing interest rates. So there's a lot of countervailing things here for an investor, and I'll tell you. I mean, you could bounce this off of Gary, who has skin in the game. I think this is the perfect time to be in cash. And for this reason, Charles, if you really think about it, we might or might not have a trade war. We may or may not have economic slowdown. If the Fed is thinking of not raising rates, we're having an economic slowdown, which is generally not great for stocks and corporate earnings. I mean, damn, if there's ever a time to be cautious, it seems like right now.
And Melissa, to that point, when this article came out, the headline of the article, by the way, restrained inflation reduces urgency for quarterly rate increase pattern. This was music to Wall Street's ears. Someone stepped in, a group of somebodies stepped in and started buying this market.
Well, I mean, there's two ways to look at it here. You can look at it and say, well, everyone's panicking, everything's selling off, or this could be a good buying opportunity because prices obviously are lower. And a lot of companies that are very strong still, Apple, Amazon, you know, all the tech names out there. But I will say right now, we could still continue to drop. I am bullish in the market, and I think we hold the uptrend, but we don't know where we go from here. There's too much news, too much reaction. And I will say, even though the news broke last night about this arrest, if you look at the time of the dates, the big sell-off happened on Tuesday, and so December 1st was Saturday, so you got to kind of wonder if some people knew that that had happened before the news broke to the national media.
Gary, it's unlikely most of our viewers are going to go into all cash. They got 401ks, and even those who don't, you know, probably want to hold on to some of these names. You're one who watches and listens to the actual minute-to-minute action today. We hit a low that a lot of people said we had to hit technicians, and we bounced off of it. We closed where we wanted to close. We got that big jobs report tomorrow. Hash it all out for us.
Well, I'm not crazy doing the minute by minute, but Charlie's right on one very important thing. Last week, the Fed tried talking easy. Market went up and then dropped 1,500 points. So guess what the Fed did today? They reannounced it to hopefully put a backstop on the market. For me, the most important thing that happened today was we hit a low, rallied up. We hit the low again, rallied up. We just hit it again and reversed. So probably for now, another low in place. We're in December, we'll rally up, but I got news for you. There's 1,200 new yearly lows at this point in time. Financials have been wrecked. So many areas of the markets are in trouble, and the markets are seeing something fundamentally not having to do with the Fed. So I think December may be okay. I worry about January, but I think today was the best down 80 I've seen in the market in history.
Or up 790, depending on your point of view.
Right? That's a good point.
Got you.
Oh, no, I was going to say that I don't think the market had advanced work. Or there was some alleged, you know, kind of, this is an insider trading, but that traders knew about the arrest earlier. I mean, I think Monday's sell-off was, you know, on tariff, man. I mean, markets hate tariffs.
Tuesday.
Yeah, Tuesday, I'm sorry.
100% right.
Right. I mean, they hate tariffs. I mean, you know, it's just the market is on edge when it comes to trade and Trump. They don't think that he has a coherent plan. I mean, he may in the back of his mind, but he's not. There is a mad method to Donald Trump's madness. We all know that. But the markets don't see it right now, so they're going to trade off on this stuff. And I will say this, you know, okay, December might be a better month going forward and all that, but again, if the Fed is signaling that it's going to normalize slower, which is essentially what that Wall Street Journal article said, that means it's worried about the economy, which generally isn't good for corporate earnings.
Although they were on automatic pilot, and I think that scared people. They're going to go data dependent. So if the data's strong, they hike. If the data's not, they won't. And I think
sounds
that's
like,
music to Wall Street.
Sounds like, Janet Yellen, doesn't it?
Guys, we've got to leave it there. Hey, new reports, former Attorney General, a general under H.W. Bush could be President Trump's next pick.